hear that?
My God.
Somebody was attacked.
But it seems everyone is fine.
Either someone miraculously healed themselves, or someone is not who they say they are.
Het is een prequel van een bestaande film uit 1982 van John Carpenter. Deze film speelt zich 3 dagen vooraf voor die andere film. En het gaat over een Noors expeditiekamp waarin ze een vliegende schotel vinden, begraven onder het ijs. Ze vinden daar een soort van fossiel van een alien. Dat graven ze uit en dat beest barst los. En vermoordt uiteindelijk waarschijnlijk iedereen in dat kamp.
What was it doing to him?
It's imitating his cells. I think this thing copies its prey and then hides inside it.
What are you saying?
Not all of us are human. It could be any of us.
He definitely has a European sensibility in the sense that he likes things to be slow and quiet and subtle, long takes, things like that. I think a lot of, you know, more American modern horror films are really fast-paced and slick and modern, and things have kind of gotten into a style that I don't like as much necessarily, and I love more classic horror films like Alien and, you know, The Shining and things like that, and that's the stuff that he loves as well. And so those were the kind of references. Also, of course, The Thing was the big reference, but other than that, you know, other classic horror films as well. And he was so lovely to work with, just really smart and sweet and really collaborative. And yeah, it was really a joy.
Watch them.
They attacked him. They got Lush. Peter, they are Lush.
What happened?
Peter, keep them back.
You were young men.
Stay on them, Peter.
You are Lush. What happened?
You are Lush. Peter, I recall something.
They don't know who we can trust. We don't know if we can trust them.
It's obviously outside. It's obviously not.
Stay on them. Stay on them, Peter. Just let them go.
They're inside.
Okay, als je dus open splijt, hè? Hoe toont het zich? En gewoon ja, dat hele proces van dat design, hè? Ja, dat is natuurlijk geweldig. En met allemaal designers en kleien. En zeggen, oh, dat is cool, zo ziet het er cool uit. Of, ik heb altijd wel liefde gehad voor genre, horror-genre-achtige. Niet specifiek slash horror of zo, maar gewoon films waar het normaal begint en langzaam zo afdaalt naar iets heel macabers. Dat vind ik altijd heel fascinerend.